Have you ever been editing your Showit website and tried to make text bold and it either looks ever so slightly bold or not bold at all? I know how frustrating this can be, and I'm going to show you a super simple fix so that you can actually have bold text within your site. Here's a quick example. On this site here, say I want to make this first part of the sentence bold. I'm going to click the little B here and nothing happens. Kind of a letdown. And if I preview this page, you're going to see the same thing. It actually looks a little bit fuzzy. It definitely doesn't look bold, but something looks not quite right about it. Hi, I'm Galen. I'm a web designer and marketing strategist, and today I'm going to show you exactly how to fix this, and it might be easier than you think. Some people say you need custom code, but you actually don't. The first thing you want to do is go to your design settings within Showit and click on fonts. For me, I know I am using the Poppins normal font for my paragraph text. What we want to do is come here and scroll down and try to find the Poppins bold font. So first we're just going to find Poppins, and then here where it says normal, instead of normal, we are going to choose bold. And then we're going to click add Google font. And if you're not using a Google font, you want to make sure that you upload the WOFF file version of the bold font that you have. So you're going to have the regular font, then you're going to have the bold version of that same font. You need to make sure that both of them are showing up in your active fonts list. Now that I'll hit save, we're good there. You can see it's already showing up as bold in the back end of our website. But when I preview this page, still not bold. Really frustrating. So there's a workaround for this. And what you need to do is have that same bold font somewhere else on the page. It has to be pulling somewhere from the page. Because right now, if I click this paragraph, it's only using Poppins normal. So we need to use Poppins bold somewhere else for the bold text to show up here. For me, I like to actually do this all the way down in the footer here, because this is going to show up on every single page. And that means bold text is going to show up on every single page whenever I click that little B button in the formatting settings. So we'll edit the footer. I'm going to click on the text here over on the right side, and we are going to change this from Poppins normal to Poppins bold. And I might actually shrink that down a point size or two, and just because I'm already in here editing it, I'm going to move it over to the side. Same thing here. I'm going to do copy this, Command Shift V, paste that style over to the other piece. And if you want to know more about my Showit design hacks or the way I edit my websites, make sure to go watch this other video that I have. I'm going to link it on the screen here so you can go check it out next. So once I've got this ready, I'm going to just center it over here. Same thing, center this one over here. We'll just use some of the little align tools here to clean this up. Looks pretty good, and I'm actually going to delete that there in the center. Okay, so now we have Poppins bold. We are pulling Poppins bold into the footer here. And because it's in the footer, it's going to be on every page of our website. Now I don't have to do anything else. When I preview this page, the Poppins bold font is going to show up. So that's it. Super quick tutorial for you today, just to get bold text showing up on your Showit website. Because I know that was something that was super frustrating to me when I first got started with Showit. So I hope it helps you in your Showit journey too. If you have any more questions about Showit or you want to see more tutorials, let me know in the comments below. I would love to create them for you. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.